It is my honor and privilege to call this meeting to order. Jeanette, why don't you lead us in the pledge?
Oh,
you don't have to get up.
I, well, I could, but I won't. Thank you very much. Everybody ready? Okay. Begin.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, liberty, and justice for all.
There you go. All right, roll call, Mr. Secretary.
And agenda? Okay, for the Executive Committee, President Thomas.
Here.
Vice President Benjamin.
He's excused absence.
John Hendry, Secretary, here. Treasurer Hopp.
Here.
Mr. Lazarovitz.
Here.
That is the entire Executive Committee.
We have a quorum and we can conduct business. Comments from the chair, nothing at this time. Public comment, anyone? Going once.
Have an addition to the agenda, do you want that at the end?
Or? Yeah, we'll just go right through it and put those on at the end.
Okay.
Cool, thank you, Charles. Secretary's report, Mr. Hendry.
I had the July minutes finished.
Okay, so July minutes. And then did we ever do the special public safety?
Up.
Okay, so July minutes. And we approved the June last month.
Yes, we did.
All right, so I'll put it on the agenda as approved special public safety summit minutes and then the July minutes. Very good. Treasurer's report, Ms. Hopp.
Okay, I tried to print out the little invoice to tell me what was spent this past month, which really wasn't a lot. There was the $2,500 that I snuck through there for the police department, which I thought was so clever. And then there's a couple of little things that Howard told me that he got through a phone call the other day, but he hasn't sent me anything yet. So I don't know the exact amount. When I tried to sign in today to print that sucker out, it told me I had the wrong password. And I said, no, I don't. And I did it a second time, and it said no. And the third time, it boot you out. So I said, okay, I'm waiting till tomorrow to try again. So it should be fine. I don't know what I did, but I must have not held the key down too long or held the caps lock on or something. So anyway, I will get that tomorrow to verify, but I will have a report. It's not going to be a whole lot that was spent because, like I said, it was the end of the year when we closed out. I do have a budget advocate report briefly, and I'll let Miriam read it again because she likes that. It makes her feel like she's doing something. I have Glenn Bailey doing some of the, no, not Glenn Bailey. I have Brandon Bender hitting up some of the local nearby neighborhood councils to see if they're doing what they're supposed to be doing budget advocate-wise, because a lot of them aren't. And because I know she wouldn't follow through like that, and I really have a little difficulty doing that. So I'm running him ragged as it is, and he's being pretty nice about it. But you know, old men get cranky, so I don't push my husband more than I have to.
Did we get our money yet?
No, I have not heard. But that's what I wanted to print the report out to see, because it will tell me what the total is. And I don't believe so. And there's
been
a shakeup.
We're going to be at 42.5?
I believe that was definitely confirmed, but don't quote me until we say it, because, you know, you never know until you actually see that money.
We don't have the funds yet.
Right, we don't have the funds yet. But what scares me, though, is there's been a shakeup down there, and a number of people have left. And I'm sure you saw the email from Amber Meshack, who left, which was no loss because she never really did anything for us anyway.
And Merlo?
Merlo left?
No, I thought he's on an extended vacation or something.
Do you have a nervous breakdown? Did I finally get him?
You wore him down?
How about Jeffrey?
I'm sorry, I'm being recorded. I shouldn't say that.
Jeffrey
after what he put me through, hey, it's totally fair. There were like several people. They were the high mucky muckers. So they did bring in someone whose name escapes me at the moment, but which was a good thing. She did get approval. She's had approval, actually, for several more additions to her department, but they had the funding, but they couldn't find the bodies. So I think we kept suggesting through the budget advocates that they do a little more streamlining, because there are still some duplications of effort. Take those people and put them in these openings, you know. So, I mean, there, then you've got somebody that's already been vetted for the city, and now just stick them in the job, for gosh sakes. So they're trying to do that. I mean, like, why didn't they do that themselves? Anyway, so I will have a brief report for her. We had a number of meetings. We've already got committees going. We've already met several times. We've decided on some of our goals. We've elected chairpersons and vice chairpersons, of which I'm a vice chair in two committees. They tried to talk me into chairmanship, and I said, no thanks. Too busy already. No, it's really just a lack of being able to get around easily. Really working toward the goals to improve things. And then the biggest thing that I was concerned about, which you guys already have on the agenda, is, like I said, the Great Streets Initiative, which, did we find out if we won that or not? Because there were, he supposedly made announcements, and there was some pictures on the website, and it showed us, but I don't know if that meant we...
The person who, the Eric Land Institute, won the grant for the Van Nuys area. So
he will be helping us?
Who?
That fellow? I mean, does that mean he's going to help us with our section of it that was supposed to be renovated, or do we lose out?
What do you mean?
Well, back when he was announcing that, Van Nuys was supposed to be one of the Great Street Initiative.
Uh-huh. Yeah, this is somewhat same, but it's a little different because it's a grant, because it's like a competition.
Right.
And so they're doing it right now, and just last week they announced the...
That's why I was asking.
Yeah.
Because it was a big deal, because they got more money because of the grant. Mm-hmm. So we could do a lot better job if we won. That's what I wanted to know.
Mm-hmm. Well, they're going to present the coming general meeting.
All right, and then, of course, Mary's thing, which is Wednesday, which we'll be talking about later, which I don't want to miss, because that's the CIS for the street vending, which is really, it looks like they're moving it forward. So we have to make sure we get our P's and Q's in there, because if we don't at least say that we want some parameters in relation to how it's going to be done, so that, in other words, for example, rather than, okay, everybody has to do it, how about an opt-in or an opt-out, whatever, if you say your individual neighborhood does not want to do it, then they should be able to opt out and not have to have that, so then they can't force them on us. That would be a good way to get around it, because of the fact that they're not. We already know they're not going to have enough people for oversight. They're not going to do any, the city attorney's office won't follow up on it. There won't probably be any citations. It's going to be difficult to follow them. And then if they have, there's two kinds, too. If they get away with the little carts that they push rather than the big, van type, they would be impossible to follow around and find. And then, of course, we all mentioned the safety issues, but there's more safety issues. I was thinking also of not just the food-borne safety issues, especially in light of the news media thingy the other day that said that there was a big recall of cilantro that had toilet tissue and feces in it. And I'm like, and it came from Mexico. And I'm like, oh, okay. And that's the kind of stuff that I worried about when I thought about those kind of vendors.
Are you buying cilantro in the
street? No, I hate cilantro. I don't eat it because it drives me insane. No, I actually, my tongue swells when I eat it. But then maybe that's why, okay? I mean, it's like, what a scary thought.
Yeah,
but,
all right, Ms. Hoff, you should have your own radio show. I've never heard that. There is no dead air at all.
No, I'm just telling you.
Thank you for that.
It's scary.
But to add to our point, there's also the economic impact of when you allow street vendors, it penalizes the businesses that are legitimate, that are contributing to the economy.
Well, I was getting that next,
exactly. That are actual, tax-paying.
Well, while we're on this, who's going to the meeting?
I am.
You're going to the meeting, so you're confirmed. You're going to the meeting?
Yes.
And then...
I'm trying to take Kathleen, but she hasn't confirmed with me yet. She wasn't home when I called, so...
And did you follow up with Jessica?
Yes, I did talk to Jessica.
And Maddie, you followed up with Jessica?
Yeah, she's going to give me a debrief. And
okay, cool.
We're already aligned.
Well, I think we're the first council that addressed this and came out against street vending. And I remember Howard and Mr. Hoff had extensive meetings on this, mm-hmm. and... we have an extensive record on our position. So,
the other thing I was going to mention was kids getting run
over.
We
line up with what Jessica is trying to do.
And so under the new umbrella of sustainability, it's a sustainable economy when you're rewarding the businesses that follow the law and contribute to the tax base, and you're dissuading businesses that don't do that. That's how it falls into the sustainability.
Fair enough. Very good.
Which is the idea. They won't be.
Yeah, that's good. I'm happy we have representation down at City Hall for this council. So very good work, you guys. Anything else, Ms. Hopp?
I don't think that's it.
All right.
I have a quick question, just background.
Yes, ma'am.
You said Mr. Hopp. Is it Mr. Hopp, Mr. Hopp, or the other Mr. Hopp?
Richard.
Got
He's
it.
Not related to me.
Got it. You told me. Okay.
Yeah.
All right, so then we can just go down the list of the new business, and then if anyone has anything, Mr. Robbins or anyone else, we'll put it on the agenda as per usual. 8A, the VNNC to host Councilmember David Rue for our Distinguished Speaker Series. We've had this on for a couple months, but Councilmember Lynn finally locked him down. So, to come and speak at our council meeting.
Which
He's
going
to be here in August.
Yeah, next month. Next week, next week.
Next week?
Yep, next week. So next Wednesday.
Yeah, I hope so.
So
we meet this guy. I've been dying to meet him.
Let's dress up and be on our best behavior and let him think that we're normal. So that's been on the agenda. We don't have to officially vote on it. It's old business, but I'll just leave the exact same language on. Good work, Mr. Lynn, on that. 8B.
Mr. President?
Yes.
It's technically called a consent item. So what you're doing has a name. It's a consent item.
Okay, I mean.
So it's being relegated to a consent item.
Okay, relegated to a consent item. Very good.
Are you consenting to it?
I
doesn't matter. It's already been done.
Why not?
That's what it means. When it's already taken care of and
it's already voted
there's
upon.
No one,
right.
There's no discussion and there's no need to argue or whatever. It's just a consent item. And then during the
if you don't argue, then it's not a meeting.
It wouldn't be us without an argument.
I don't argue with that.
Are we arguing whether or not we're arguing? I think that's what we're
talking about.
To streamline it during the general meeting and just keep things going, you just go to the consent item and you move on to the next item.
Well, you know what? I'm going to put it on the agenda as a consent item and see if Dunn says anything. So they'll be like, that's new. I don't know what they're doing over there. All right, consent item 8A. We're in business on that one. 8B, connect the dots. The Winning Great Streets Challenge Grant is seeking for funds the Arid Lands Institute, LA County Bike Coalition. Didn't we do this exact thing before?
But they just wanted a letter of support from the last meeting.
Okay.
Since they already won, then they're doing a crowdfunding campaign.
How much do they want?
Well,
we don't have any money.
$42,500?
We could go for that.
Why not? We'll just
kill.
Spend it in one fell swoop.
So I don't know how you want to delineate it at your meeting, but that's going to conflict directly with the Sustainability Committee, because that's what the Sustainability Committee would be doing. Meaning, we don't need to be funding an outside third-party vendor. What makes us unique as a neighborhood council is that we have a Sustainability Committee, and if I do say so myself, a chair, that can do exactly what that third-party vendor does for other communities, but we could save money and the board should have a discussion to see which one it would rather do, because that's something that the Sustainability Committee can do, and it parlays into our efforts to update the community plan update that we have resources and assets and you know the allies to do.
Well, the thing on this, there's more than one committee that would have jurisdiction over this. So in those cases,
planning and land use.
What I'd like to do is have us go into what's called a committee on the whole, where everyone on the council is now in this committee on the whole. If you look it up in the Robert's Rules of Order and in the legislative parliamentary procedure, it's very common. The U.S. Congress does it. The state legislatures do it. So that way, it's under your committee. It's also under Carino's committee. Nobody's stepping on anyone's feet, and we can all address it as a council.
And I'm all good with that. I consent to that. The issue is it doesn't fall into our bylaws that are filed with Dunn. So that's another issue.
Allowed to become a committee on the whole, and we've done it before.
Yes,
we've done it before. Before you were on the council, we used to do this. And it didn't conflict with the Dunn or any city attorney.
Then it'd be an ad hoc committee, and it wouldn't be a standing committee.
No, it's really a committee on the whole. So
it means everybody.
It's involving the whole council.
It's involving everybody.
It's involving the whole council.
Ad hoc doesn't involve everybody.
As long as it's on the agenda, once you have it on the agenda, you give them 72 hours notice. It doesn't matter what. It's an open meeting, and therefore you can go ahead.
That's not in our bylaws.
Okay, well, we've done it before, and it's gone through just fine.
We have a shopping list going of all the things that we need to reconcile between Dunn and our bylaws.
You have a shopping list. You're the only one with a list.
Because we have our bylaws that have not been actually put on site.
So what you can do is go ahead and...
I'm meeting with the head of DUNS.
Good, meet with whoever you want. So we'll go ahead and put that on the agendas committee on the whole. I'll call for the, do I have a second?
Second.
And I call for the vote on that, Mr. Secretary?
Just a second, okay.
Wait, give me a number first, though. What do we, what's our number for the funding?
So just clarification, are all three groups seeking funding?
No, they're part of the whole grant. They're a group, they're a team.
Oh, I see, okay. They're not seeking individual pots of money.
And Carino, you need to fully disclose your role with the Los Angeles County Bicycle Coalition.
Yeah, because I'm a member.
Right.
Yeah.
So you need to put that on record. You need to disclose that.
No, what he would do at the time of a vote is recuse himself.
Yeah.
That's the rule, that's the law, that's in the bylaws.
You keep cutting me off at these meetings.
You know, I'm gonna stand up, Mr. President.
You're recognized, Jamie.
Yes.
Listen,
You're no longer president of this committee.
He's recognized.
He's recognized.
He's recognized.
Listen, I don't know what your problem is with either me or others on this council, but you appear to be able to know all and have all knowledge. I don't have a problem with that. But you have a real control issue as far as what other people have input on, whether it be a committee or executive committee or whatever. I would appreciate it that if you just sit there, and if you want a discussion afterwards with people, do that. Don't try to put me down in front of a committee just like you did over at the Plum Committee. I mean, that's, for you, it's very, very rude. And I'm done with your nonsense because, you know what, I'll pull the trigger and have you removed from the board. And if you don't think I'll do that, keep pushing because you're not real welcome right now with a lot of people that I'm talking to because of your almost like arrogance to the rest of the board members and the rest of the stakeholders. So with that being said, Mr. President, I just want to fill you in is that, you know, I understand the bylaws, I help write the bylaws, and I just don't need others to come in here and start slamming you, other members of the executive committee, or the executive board, or the boards.
So can I answer that, Mr. President?
Sure.
We have processes that are harming our local community, and the processes that I was given, the bylaws that I was given by Amber at Dunn.
That's why she's not there anymore.
Right, but DUNN still exists. And to your point about your views, I also have supporters among the community. So I'm happy to bring my supporters among the community who are unhappy with the service that this board is providing.
Bring them on.
Oh, boy.
Bring them on.
And we're getting that Pico Rico.
And we're getting to that point where we're really going to get upset.
Week.
So let's.
Let them know we're not getting
be
Subway.
Civil.
I'm being civil.
Pico Rico.
I'm just.
Yes.
Moving on.
Really
all right, so give me a number for this one, Karina.
$999.
Well, can we start with $2,500 and?
Oh, jeez, you're killing me.
But it's three different.
No,
groups,
well, it's
right?
it's
no,
the
he's trying to
it's
give
the
one.
Whole team.
So
it's all one coalition.
Team, but
yeah.
Are you going to distribute it between the three?
So if you go $1,500, everybody gets $500. I mean, that would be
yeah. They'll
well, if we get 900,
they'll give a presentation
yeah,
how much is going to be spent, but also they'll also tell there's a crown funding for individuals to donate as well.
This is a big coalition.
I'm happy with
the
whatever number we want to put
yeah,
on it. We'll
yeah,
argue about it next
week.
Yeah,
I don't think there is any money. The city is very involved.
See, the thing is
yeah.
that there's a matching fund. Whatever you put on the I guess the campaign, the city will match it.
So they say.
So whatever's contributed, they'll go ahead and match whatever.
I'm happy to put $2,500 on the agenda, and we can discuss it until the cows come home next week.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, if we don't have any objection
God,
to that.
I guess I'm going to have to give you
a no. Do we have an objection to that?
No.
All right, so I make a
motion. I would say
$999. I think it's a lot.
Let's start, you know, the year on the right foot. We don't have that much money. We have $42,000. We can spend it in, you know, in two sessions.
Well, then,
$5,000 there.
Why let's chop two? It down. Let's chop it down to $999 next
let's
week.
Start. Let's start.
Well,
with $999.
Let's do
$2,500.
We can always do
just the fact that, you know, there's attention with the Great Street. If this becomes successful, it it'll bring more attention to Van Nuys?
Let's put 2,500 on the agenda, and then you can do 990.
If it's going to bring more attention to Van Nuys,
George,
I like those words.
Go ahead and put 2,500 NTE, not to exceed.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
And then once you do the not to exceed, there you have a window to work with. And then
once below or up to, because I'm telling you.
Then once the minutes are completed, the minutes will reflect on what was voted on, and then they get submitted.
Okay, so following the logic that it would benefit Van Nuys, how could it possibly hurt Van Nuys that an actual committee is the one that's administrating and planning the event? In March, we held a planning summit where we had the role to the community to say that we can plan sustainably in Van Nuys.
Wouldn't this be something to bring up at the general meeting?
Sure, would you like me to? Absolutely.
As the executive committee just sets the agenda?
Sure, absolutely, agree.
Right?
Will do.
You know, so we can get through all this?
Sure.
So, the motion on the floor is that we accept the language in 8B as is. We go into a committee on the whole for everyone on the council to have feedback on this, and not to exceed $2,500.
I second it.
With that, I call for the vote, Mr. Secretary.
Okay, President Thomas.
Yes.
Secretary Hendry, aye. Treasurer Hawk.
Aye.
Mr. Lucero.
Aye.
Pass.
Very good. Next up, 8C, 6075 Van Nuys Boulevard, a conditional use to expand the existing conditional use of selling alcohol, a request for a conditional use to allow for the expansion, deemed to be approved general off-sale alcohol license for an existing 24-hour convenience mart. Is this the one by the bus station?
Yeah.
Bus stop?
Yeah.
This is the orange line one?
The orange line.
Okay.
Yeah.
So what is it, a restaurant or it's a...
Nope.
No, it's a 7-Eleven.
7-Eleven by the orange line?
Stop and go converter.
Stop and go. Stop and go.
Stop and go. Oh.
It's right by the diet store or whatever.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, mm-hmm. That same little...
Okay,
yeah,
so
I got a question.
Sandy, you're probably not for that. I would guess.
Well, you know, when we talked about the during the plum committee, we talked about conditions.
Yeah.
Being placed on it.
I do have a type of conditions if you want to.
Yeah, which we discussed. You know, the hours of operation. We originally had discussed with him from 8 to 12, and he would like to go back to 6 a.m. to 12.
Oh, no.
We discussed signs around the property, that which are all by law. We discussed increased lighting around the store, around the area. Also,
will he adhere to any of this?
Gonna have to. That's part of the conditions.
Yeah.
Well, we're only advisory, so.
That's right.
Oh, Jamie, what scares me though
is near
the orange line, you're gonna get. People
we
getting
discussed
drunk
it.
And getting on that and hanging
We've
around.
Yeah, we already discussed it. We went through everything at the plum meeting.
I'm just saying that's scary.
However, the biggest stick is that Mr. Michaels had mentioned that and there's other conditions for stores similar to this one selling alcohol that had security at it.
Mm.
When we had mentioned that they should have a security guard between. So many hours. Oh, well, that would just put the store out of business and this, that.
Yeah, I know that.
Which, later on down the road, it ended up where it wasn't exactly that case. So I found out that other stores do have security, doesn't put them out of business, and the guy basically lied to the committee straight to everybody.
So he thinks if there's a security guard, then the guy won't want to buy some whiskey at 6 in the morning?
Yeah,
well,
the
other
he'll
be worried
is
about
the
his
owner.
How about security cameras?
Oh, the security.
There's part of the condition.
Penelope.
The owner of that property also owns the one at Sherman Way and
Van Owen.
Van Owen in Sepulveda.
Yep.
Okay.
He has, since 1992, a full-time security guard, I believe. And
I don't see the guy there all the time.
So is that one of our conditions?
Yeah. No, that's a total different project because they're gonna.
Total different project, but it hasn't put them out of business. The security guard.
No, so his statement contradicts his own business.
That's why
he doesn't
want to
spend the money,
and he knew it.
Yeah, he doesn't want to spend the money.
He just doesn't want to spend the money.
So I'm sorry.
He does not have a buy right for anything there. I mean, obviously it has to come through us. It has to. go through LAPD, so.
On ABC?
He really wasn't upfront about that.
So why don't we put it on the agenda and then bring him before us next week and see what happens?
Yeah, let's hammer him. Let's ask him some questions.
Let's slice him and dice him. 8C, I make a motion that we adopt the language in 8C as is.
I'm seconded.
With that, I call for the vote, Mr. Secretary.
President Thomas?
Yes.
Secretary Hendry, yes. Treasurer Hawk?
Yes.
Mr. Lazarus?
Aye. Pass.
Very good. Next up, this was just an email that came into the info at VNNC. The VNNC to address the concerns of Albert Hernandez. He writes, hello, I'd like to know if attending the neighborhood council meeting would give me a chance to see if something can be parking. Done about yes. the parking in my neighborhood.
Of course.
So we can leave this on the agenda like this and then just invite him to the meeting and listen to his concerns.
Can you shoot him an email, invite him?
Yes.
Tell him to come in front of the board.
What is his address?
I don't know. It's in the email.
It wasn't there. But it was, because I forwarded exactly what comes to us.
Let's just invite him to the meeting.
Yeah.
So I make a motion we adopt the language in 8D as is. With that, I call for the vote.
Hey, President Thomas?
Yes.
George, I went down Reseda Boulevard yesterday or the day before, and all they have is poles now.
Let's get through the vote, Miriam, and then I'll ask you about Reseda.
Because that's the one you're talking about, the bike? I mean,
No. I voted yes.
No, that's...
We're on
yes.
E.
We're on E.
I know, but I'm...
Ms. Hopp, well, let's get through the vote, Miriam, and then we'll jump right into that.
Aye.
No, that's... We already did it.
Okay, let's get through this vote, and then we will find out about Miriam traveling down Reseda Boulevard.
Oh, she did?
Yes. Great street initiatives, be nice.
All right. How's our budget advocate doing? I hear you're going to a meeting tomorrow or Wednesday?
I'm a budget rep.
You are?
Yes.
Oh.
And how are you doing?
Miriam, you were traveling in Reseda. You want to tell us about that?
Yeah, I don't like it because it's going to take parking away from Van Nuys Boulevard. We need the parking for our businesses. And that's important for them to have that parking.
With the little parklets? You don't like the little parklets?
No,
is that what you're saying?
No, I don't.
Have you been up there to see it?
No, is it brand new?
They have it, it's basically around the college. It runs, I think, from Parthenia all the way up past
It's way out of the district.
And it actually, what it does is it takes the whole right lane, the third lane, and that's critical on Van Nuys during rush hour, especially morning and evenings. But they take it away, and instead of pulling to the curb, now there's only a few spaces out where the lane would be, and they've got half of that taken for the bicycle lane.
Is this part of the Great Streets thing that
yes.
you came up
yes.
with?
Yes. What it is the only areas where you can cross with a car are painted or marked green. So it's real difficult. I've been up there to do some shopping and.
Is it dangerous? Because I mean,
I don't see anybody in the bike lanes, and you know the school is.
Most people use that third lane. I mean, there's a special valley driving.
Right.
It's like nowhere else in the world where they get past the
path using
that third lane.
And the biggest thing is instead of being just everything's flat, they have the markers. You know, like the road cones, the markers that are glued right on the street with reflectors. So it does take away that entire third lane. So there's no way to reuse that lane during rush hour, morning or evenings.
Penelope, then Donna.
Broadway downtown has cut the lanes. Two going south, one going north, and then they have cutouts. The whole street with umbrellas, seating, it's actually quite lovely. And they're trying to get, what it's doing is getting people out walking and shopping. Mm-hmm. So in a way,
so it can be implemented in a good way.
And then they've got some parking structures.
Yeah, wait till
the red line kind of drops you off right in
the
city area.
There's more people living on that.
Donna Pearman.
Yeah, okay, and Reseda, what they do is the first lane is the, first lane is driving, I believe. Second lane is parking. And the third lane over there is the bikes. Nobody's using the bike lane. Oh no, the first one must be the bike lane.
Yeah.
No one's using the bike lane. The bikes are all on the street. I'm never seeing them on there because when they come over to the, to go up, to go across the street, they would be in the street. So what they do is they go on the sidewalk and then go over. They're parked in the middle of the street for parking, which means then if the pedestrian got out, they're actually technically walking in the way of cars or bikes.
We're talking about VNNC or...
No, they want to do this in VNNC.
It's a little different because there's different sets of circumstances.
If people get out of the cars, people start walking, using the bikes.
Well, the problem is the rush hour.
Maybe second story.
Okay, so to circle back to what we were talking about, one of the key consultants and advisors that we have for the Sustainability Committee is a Portland transportation planner who specializes in complete streets. So what we're talking about are road diets and a complete streets paradigm in urban planning, and that's why I really think and hope that we drive the great streets, because then it's coming from a community-centric focus, and we have the advisors to be pushing back on the mayor's office rather than having Aaron Lands do it because they're working for the mayor's office. That's the differential.
Fair enough.
What kind of plan do you have? The same thing?
All right, we'll get into that next week.
I don't have any plans at all.
All right, next up, 8E, the VNNC to implement and fulfill the vision of the Education Reform Summit. We are hosting this August. The VNNC to invite every principal from the Van Nuys schools and conduct a symposium addressing the current issues facing our schools. The VNNC to come up with a plan to fund after-school programs and anti-gang initiatives. I had an at-length conversation with Councilwoman Raines about the Education Summit. She is going to be on the phone tomorrow inviting every principal in Van Nuys to come and speak before our council. What we're also going to do is, before the summit, we will have our committee chair training. So all of the committee chairs that want to start meeting and get everything going will be completely trained as per the Ralph M. Brown Act, the FPPC, the CIA, the FBI, everything that we have to do. Empower LA and the mayor's office.
Ethics committees.
And the Prime Minister of Canada. Everyone, it's going to be all checked off and legitimate and legal. Carino does a fine job adhering to the Ralph M. Brown Act. Years ago, when him and Jerry took over the Plum Committee, we had an extensive sit down and went over everything. Carino, I want you there to kind of brief the other chair people about basically it's the legalities of this council's CYA-ing, which, you know, we basically want to not be subject to the lawsuits and litigation and everything else because this wasn't taped to the door in time. So what we're gonna do is the training first, and then we will get into Stacy's Education Reform Summit. I think it's a good idea that we hear from the principals, every principal in Van Nuys. I spoke to Fran, who's the principal of Van Nuys Elementary, and she said, hey, if you got a couple $1,000 for us, we'd love new computers and a computer bay, which led me to think that we should ask every principal what they need. Stacy's also going to reach out to the two LAUSD reps that we have, whoever the new Tamar is, and then the other lady who sends her field rep that speaks at every one of our meetings. That's right. So we'll invite both LAUSD reps, every principal, and that should give Stacy enough to have her committee meetings for months on end. So without objection, we can do two separate items, or we can lump it all in.
No, you have to do it separately, and you have to send an email to all the board members to make sure, especially the committee chairs.
We also have a done coming after a couple council members saying that they weren't completely trained. And we all know how difficult it is to deal with the Department of Neighborhood Empowerment, and sometimes they're wrong, believe it or not.
They won't admit it, though.
If these council people aren't trained and they are aware of it, right? You could be trained, like, Mr. Henry took the training and then we forgot to email it in. So they had him as not trained, but he was.
But he was.
The same thing happened to me, and I had to go back and redo it because I didn't email someone in Sacramento about it.
When I went to the Congress of Neighborhoods, I thought I went to some training, and I wasn't. So then whenever I found out about it, I had to take it.
So,
me too. I did the ethics training.
Yeah.
And I actually forwarded
it.
And they tried to say that I wasn't either.
And then, if you guys remember when we brought in Jay Handel to train us all, we went through this a couple months ago.
He's really good.
Howard oversaw it. They didn't accept half of those. So,
ridiculous.
Everyone's going to be trained again if you're on the list because we don't want to lose council people because they don't have their paperwork from us. So
it should be everybody's responsibility, though. You shouldn't have to.
Right. Well, I saved mine and brought it
so
in.
What we could do
I've
is
got to show them.
For
I
the
mean, you either do it or you don't.
Yeah, of course.
So for the committee chair training, we can also throw in ethics.
There's one person that's been on the board for years. He's never done anything.
Who?
Doesn't matter who.
Oh, okay.
I don't need to make.
Well, let's just set the time frame here, though. If Stacy's Reform Summit starts at 6:30. You think 5 o'clock is a good enough time to start the training?
Yeah, 5 o'clock is plenty.
The 19th of August. 5 o'clock or 5:30, 5:30 to 6:30? What are we thinking? Let's call it 5:30.
It'll always go over, you know that, because of questions and answers.
People aren't going to show up.
Well, then if they don't show up, and that's that. But
hold their hand.
Well, you want to call it 5:30, 5:30 to 6:30?
5:30.
Okay, so what we'll do, from 5:30 to 6:30 on August 19th, we will have the committee chair training and any additional ethics and funding training if needed. I make a motion that for the hour before the Education Reform Summit, we have our committee chair training.
Second.
With that, I call for the vote, Mr. Secretary.
President Thomas.
Yes.
Secretary Hendry, aye. Treasurer Hupp?
Aye.
Mr. Lazarus?
Aye.
Pass.
So with this, I'm going to reach out to Dunn. I don't know who the new Amber Meshack is. I don't know who the old Thomas Sung is. But we need to find out who our rep is and have them come to this. We'll also reach out to Jay Handel, who wants to train us for some reason. So we'll let him be involved in that. And I guess if worse comes to worse, I will go over all the requirements for the Brown Act so everyone can start having their committee meetings.
You said Thomas, I got the email that Amber had resigned, but was Thomas Song the other guy that was at our facilitated meeting, he's gone too?
No,
he's
just
used
to be
represents,
our rep. He represents another area now.
Yes, but it doesn't matter. We need somebody from Dunn there, Jay Handel there. We'll go over the Ralph M. Brown Act, and the world will keep turning. All right, so that's on the agenda. Now for Stacy's Education Reform Summit, we can just accept the language as is to fulfill the vision, conduct the symposium with the principals. Do we have any objection to any of that? So I make a motion we adopt the language in 8E as is.
Second that. What's the language, by the way?
It says, the VNNC to implement and fulfill the vision of the Education Reform Summit we are hosting this August. The VNNC to invite every principal from the Van Nuys schools and conduct a symposium addressing the current issues facing our schools. The VNNC to come up with a plan to fund after-school programs and anti-gang initiatives.
Second.
There it is. I call for the vote, Mr. Secretary.
President Thomas?
Yes.
Got a question?
Sandy had her hand up.
Oh.
I was
Ms. Logan.
Wondering if we could attend that as well.
You can attend all of their public meetings, Sandy. Bring your Colts fan friend, and we're there. We're in the middle of the vote. Are we good? I vote yes. Joseph voted yes.
Secretary Henry votes yes. Treasurer Hawk?
Aye.
Yes.
Mr. Lazarevich?
Yes.
Very good.
Do you have a date for that yet?
Wednesday, August 19th. All right, and then the last thing I have before we open it up to the rest of the council people, the VNNC to hear a speech and presentation from Jessica Horick about illegal street vending the VNNC to continue to support its position on illegal street vending and to work with local community leaders to address this issue. Tomorrow, Wednesday, Ms. Hopp, Ms. Agrisarian, right?
Asgarian.
And possibly
Kathleen Badden.
All right, are going to go and represent us with
I'm
the.
I'm going too.
Well, yes. That.
Now
it's a party.
Yes.
All right, and I look forward to hearing what comes out of that. Jessica is in line with us. Like I said, our council was the first one to take a position on this. You guys know the drill. But Jessica wants to come and speak before our council next week, so I make a motion that we adopt the language in 8F as is. And with that, I call for the vote.
President Thomas?
Yes.
Secretary Hendry, aye. Treasurer Hopp?
Aye.
Mr. Lazar?
Aye.
And I have one more thing before I turn it over to Charles. Our former president, Derek Wolenko, has resigned.
Oh,
so he let me know
that's
that
why he hasn't been around.
He is resigning from this council. Him and his wife are expecting their firstborn.
That's the case.
And I told him that we're all very thankful for his service, that he's always been the voice of reason when we start arguing too much, that we should do something nice for him. I don't know, maybe we could
have
cupcakes.
Maybe we could buy him a crib.
We could buy him a bounce house.
That would be for him. The wife and the baby will sleep in the bed.
Yeah, that's right.
Maybe a Subway somewhere.
That's right.
But I said that I'd like him to stay on until the September meeting. And the reason I did that was because that's how long it will take the other offices to do the honorifics. Usually, like when someone serves on the council, Adrene Nazarian's office will give him a little thing, and we could get Sheila Kuehl's office to do a nice thing. And he agreed to serve until September, but I want to bounce it off you guys. We can, should we have a fireworks show? Make a statue. We can
like
put
I
the
said,
stat.
Can I
make
him
it,
that boat?
We can.
Can I? Can I drop the
yes,
ball?
Yes, we could give him the boat.
Give him the yeah.
Well,
boot, you know.
Yeah.
We could make a statue right next to San Fernando in front of the court. Mr. Hendry.
I'll get him the horse.
She is in the Texas. Texas Tech softball Hall of Fame.
Is she really?
Yes.
Who is?
Careful, Michael's wife.
What is Texas Tech's
Red
mascot?
Red
are they
running?
Yeah.
Red Raiders.
Well, then what's
Red
Texas
Raiders.
Christian?
No, that's the Horned Frogs.
They're the Horned Frogs.
I'm not even from Texas, and I'm just being mixed
up. Yeah, it's like we're in a Jeopardy thing right now.
He knows his stuff.
What should we do for Derek besides just trying to get him a certificate
Adios.
From Adrene's office?
Bye bye.
Well, yes, Jeanette. Jeanette really, I guess that's Jeanette enjoying her recall election. And Jeanette will be...
Well, you know, the best thing we can do is just acknowledge him at a meeting. You know, we have cupcakes.
Yeah,
or something like
right,
that.
A nice cake.
We just leave it like that because, remember, the board cannot purchase not even one plaque. They cannot out of their own pocket.
And that's almost like...
You cannot give anything to that member. It's got to come out of your own pocket.
Some of the bad things
so then we'll do like a cake or cupcakes,
right.
And
then that
we'll work on
that.
The other higher offices giving
that
honorifics.
That can be given. Right.
Yeah.
Maddie.
Yeah, so what we can do to go along those lines is this is an opportunity for us to recognize a local business. So perhaps we can solicit a local business to provide whatever it is that we want to give them. And
like
that way we acknowledge the local business.
Oh, I need that.
We acknowledge
well, there
the
is a new Maserati
business.
Dealership
yes.
in Van Nuys.
Yes, yes.
No, that's a sports car. I can't
I think you like
consent
to
item. Consent item.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. That's a stick
okay, well,
shift. I can't do that.
But
so
the,
let's
the
do.
Idea is, we have an opportunity to win-win. Recognize the council member for their efforts and recognize a local business and show our value to the business community by doing that.
Okay, you want to be in charge of going soliciting the businesses, see what we can get
you
for
you? You know what? So we have an outreach chair. I'd like to talk to Maria, so I don't
That's fine.
Okay.
So, but as it stands right now, we'll do like cake or cupcakes at the September meeting, and it's August 3rd, so that gives us enough time to get the other governments and levels of government above us to do their little...
Okay, a couple of MOAs, and while we're on that subject, let me sneak it in, because there's one thing I didn't say, which was, at the senior symposium thingy that Kathleen and I so graciously attended and put our booth up for, and we're a little bit disappointed about where they put it, but that's nonetheless okay. We still got a large response. And then one time I run out of cards and I really need them. Everybody's uncle wanted one. I didn't have enough on me. I personally paid for the translation out of my pocket. The long and the short of it was I was asked to help augment getting that. And I went through my resources, and here you're talking about helping LA Unified, and you know I volunteered for them for 25 years. And I love them on one respect, and I'd like to shoot them on the other, because I went to my resources. Now, several of the people with whom I worked really closely have retired. But I went to the local administrator, Alvaro Alvarenga, and he didn't even have the decency to give me a phone call. He sent me an email saying, no, couldn't let us use them. And I thought that was pretty sad. I could have gone to the board members, but I don't know them that well because a lot of them are new. The ones that I knew really well have either have passed on to their greater reward, or they're no longer on the board for some seriously scary reasons, like Julie Kornstein. So I didn't have those really close contacts to ask. So anyway, she said, go ahead and get it. And when I was turned down by them, and I was turned down by the city, and the city should have provided it, and they do have it, but it's in disrepair. They don't take care of it. So since they didn't have anything we could use, I went online, found a place, and got the guy to give it to us at a discount, and she was supposed to provide the funds, and oops, she forgot. Luckily for her, I had enough money in my pocket because it was $250. So I paid it. I'm not asking the council for reimbursement yet. I don't think it's fair because it was her office that was doing it. We were supposed to be co-doing it, but our name was nowhere on any flyer. So I'm just a little bit ticked about that. And she promised to bring me the funds at our next meeting. So let's see if that happens.
Let's
if it does,
see.
Everything's great. If not, then I'm going to be knocking on Adrian's door and saying, your office owes me $250, and explain why. Because that's wrong. That's wrong.
Very good. Mr. Robbins, what do you got for
us? It's actually item G, so it's a funding request.
Yes, sir. Talk to me.
Jeanette, it would have been emailed to you. It's for the Village Family Services for our run walk, which will be held. It's a Halloween fun run.
Did
October.
I get one? Because I haven't seen an email.
It was emailed to you. I'll give you a copy of this, too.
Okay, please.
October 31st, it is Metro is allowing us to use the Orange Line. We're starting at the Sepulveda Park and Ride, and going all along the Orange Line through Van Nuys to LA Valley College, and there'll be a festival at LA Valley College. So the request is to be the Van Nuys Neighborhood Council to be a major sponsor at $5,000, which Mr. Luna will appreciate, logo on t-shirts.
It's
fun. Oh, sorry, oh, I'm not online. I need to
Would you be open to a conversation with Zipcar to see if Zipcar might possibly want to sponsor?
Sure. Any sponsors. And by the way, this benefits two organizations, the Village Family Services and Valley Village, which provides support to adults
Valley
with disabilities.
They're up on Sherman Way in Winnetka?
Yeah. So it we partnered together. Last year we did it. We did it around Balboa. And this year we wanted to do it through Van Nuys.
I like that.
Yeah. And the other thing is the cadets at LAPD are volunteering their time to be the crossing guards. So
first.
And it's a Halloween fun run, so kids will be wearing costumes.
Double safety first.
It's a Saturday morning. So
Yay.
A lot
okay,
of visibility.
Like
we had 400 runners last time, and we're hoping to double that this time.
So
that's what I call a worthwhile event. I like this.
And I will volunteer my teen police advisory board kids.
Awesome.
Yep.
Can I mention a little problem with the Sepulveda
and
station? Sepulveda station is not really a good disabled station because you have to walk a long way. For anyone who's not driving, for people who are on the go on buses or walking, I just want to tell you that it's a long walk.
At the park and ride you're talking about?
Yeah.
Okay.
At the Sepulveda That's the Sepulveda Orange Line station to go to, you know, Valley Junior College. I'm hoping they someday come up with these like little trams, you know, because my legs hurt a whole lot walking all the way.
Do we get to dress up for Halloween?
Sure.
Is it one of those, like you could run as Batman or something?
So what happens is the people will park at the park and ride. Park and ride on a Saturday is virtually empty.
On Sepulveda.
There'll be a start. The runners will go first, then the walkers. They go all the way down the Orange Line to Valley College. They will get the Metro, and thanks to Sheila Kuhl, people will be given a token to be able to ride the Orange Line back to their car after the festival. So it does two things. It highlights the Metro line. It highlights the pedestrian bike path as well. And then people get a ride in the Orange Line, which I'm sure half the people
haven't. No, I'm trying to sign on so I can.
Okay, so in the interests of being completely legal, you can't vote on this.
Right, I will recuse myself. I have a staff member coming to speak on it. Can you put it like item B or C?
Item C? You wanted it as item
B or C?
We got something between. Jeanette's discussion of LAUSD budget in 1984, I can put you in between that and...
It's a fundraiser for those who normally...
No, we'll do it right after Councilmember Rue.
So,
that's fine. Okay, so...
I have a scooter and I'm having a hard time.
You can do a scooter on the ramp.
Yeah.
Sure.
And then can I get a ride back?
Miriam, you have a scooter?
Scooters go on the bus, right?
You have a metro pass, don't you?
No, on the Orange Line coming back. Can I get
I'll give him my Harley for the day.
Oh, baby!
I don't know if you can put it. Can you put it? Have you ever put it?
I want to see Joseph and Miriam on a Harley. That's what I want to see.
Me too.
That would be funny.
There's a spot for bikes, I guess.
I don't know about that.
No, I think they allow.
I'm going to bring my unicycle.
Can you tell?
And juggle the whole 5K. 3.1 miles.
Jerry would know if.
The Orange Line
gets
so many wheelchair riders that, you know.
All right, so I'm going to make a motion that we adopt this exact language that Jeanette's going to email me. The Village Run, Walk, 5K, and Family Festival will be held on Saturday, October 31st, 2015. And we'll follow the Metro Orange Line starting at the Sepulveda Station in Van Nuys and end at the corner of Burbank and Fulton, where participants will be able to enjoy a family fun festival and entertainment at LA Valley College. The event will benefit Village Family Services and Valley Village. Jeanette, you can email me that exact language?
Are they going to give candy?
When I find it, the thing is, I don't need it.
Okay.
I'm really
so I make a motion, we adopt the language and put not to exceed $5,000.
Whoa.
Hey, remember, that's
not on the one.
We
didn't vote
on
it.
I'm sure there'll be a discussion about the $5,000. Do we have a second on the motion?
A second with reservations.
All right, he seconds with reservations. Mr. Secretary, call for the vote.
I have a bad
news.
Yes.
$5,000. Where would you spend $10,000? We didn't get done yet.
Treasurer Hopp.
Wow.
We're just voting to put it on the agenda. You can slice it and dice it next week.
That's way too much money.
Yes,
All right, does anybody...
Are you kidding me?
Have anything else for the agenda? Going
Jerry.
Once. Jerry.
I was going to say, is there a way that we started our beautification analog that we had a while back?
Well, what was that? Paul?
Yeah.
And who? Paul and Carino?
Yeah.
It's just been stagnant or what?
Well, it was hard to get Paul in to get involved.
Well, do you want
to
resurrect the ad hoc? You want
to
resurrect the ad hoc? Well, then...
It can be...
Why don't we...
said he was interested in being part of that. So.
Okay.
We
could bring that back, but let's have three things that we're actually going to do instead of just we need to make Van Nuys more beautiful. We go after the pergola over here. That thing is an eyesore. Everyone talks about it. It's falling apart. I think we build a water park there.
The
water slide?
Got no water.
All right. Pool tables.
Pool tables.
Right? I would be absolutely happy to support the beautification committee coming back. with that being said, I would like two or three projects that we are actually working on. One being the pergola.
Is this the part of the horse?
The Hungle Washer, that walk, like, see if you can get, extend that, you know, north from Sherman Way, and also, you know, along the Paquama Wash there. There's a way we can create another pathway there.
Oh, was that the thing that you kept emailing me about, where they had to go over the...
No, I guess along the Hungle Washer from Burbank.
It's like a greenway. They plant...
Valley College, they've got...
So put that on the list. Yeah, I mean, if you guys are in charge of the ad hoc committee, you can put...
Whatever you want.
Yeah, you can...
As long as it falls within the parameters.
But I would like us to do something about the pergola.
Yeah, I mean, we could put that. We could also put...
We could repaint it.
We need to find a guy to build it up in Griffith Park and bring it down here.
Oh, the tea house?
Yeah.
People, I'm trying to get online while not listening to everything you said, but the last little bit I heard was pergola and all that. The last 2,500 that I snuck in that actually came out of last year's budget was for that.
For the ivy, the fake ivy, I thought.
Well, and or whatever, it was for the beautification.
No, it was LAPD.
It was LAPD, yeah. For beautification of that area. Well, the pergola's right in front of it, and it has to do with it.
Yeah, so, something should be done with the pergola.
So
yeah.
Maybe
the pergola is a common, not even rotted.
The yeah. Pergola either needs to be torn down and redone,
right.
Which is a lot of money.
Or
just come a different repurpose.
Maybe we could do a matching funds with Nuri. Maybe Nuri would like to do it.
So we put that at the top of the list for the ad hoc? You guys are free to run with it. Ad hoc away.
Maybe a mini park.
Do we have a mini park would be fun?
I like that
yes,
idea.
Ma'am.
I think that'd be good for kids.
Agenda item, I don't remember if it was June or May, but we had a Gilmore resident that Guillermo was going to take care of. It was a parking issue, and no one's followed up. So is that, I don't know that it's a proper agenda item, but we probably need Guillermo to report back to us what happened with that.
What you could
agenda.
Do is we could put it back on as old business and just readdress it.
Okay.
Right.
So email me the exact language, and I'll just put it in as old business, and then that way we can... hold his feet to the fire, so to speak. Anything else, Mr. Hendry?
Yes, I'd like to ask Dunn if they would set up a committee or something to create a community Saturday event where people could, members of neighborhood councils can go visit different parts of the city. Do things like the LA Conservancy tours, do things like asking Tom LaBonge to take us up to the Hollywood sign before it closes, etc.
My
like
house
that.
Is one of those, idea. John.
And then everyone's going to go to Penny's house for cupcakes for Derek?
I did. I had like 500 people.
Well, I believe you. Okay, so ask Dunn to do a community...
Create a community Saturday calendar, something like that,
okay.
Of events for all neighborhood council members to learn more about the city.
Yeah. I like that.
Ask Councilman LaBonge.
We're going to do something to do.
What's happening to the Hollywood sign?
Well, I know he's
what's happening to the
they're taking the
sign?
H down. It's just going to be Hollywood. They're going
to
call it Hollywood.
I thought it was Hollywood.
No, it's Hollywood now.
No, it's being moved.
They sold the H. It's now just Hollywood.
Hollywood?
Yeah.
Yep, that's
it's
it.
It's being moved.
You didn't see that, the headlines this morning?
No, I didn't have a chance to see
it. That looks
closer. To Hollywood.
Yep.
Hollywood?
What do you want the language to be?
What,
ask Dunn to do a community Saturday calendar of events for all neighborhood council members to learn more about the City of Angels.
We're just joking.
Secretary.
Neighborhood tours.
Skid Road.
Secretary Hendry to reach out and establish.
Willingly go to that one.
Reach out and establish.
It ain't coming up. This is pissing
set of ideas.
Neighborhood awareness.
Over it.
To establish
the
beginning of neighborhood awareness. The beginning.
To tone her down a little bit.
That sounds like a safety thing.
Really,
like neighborhood events.
Here.
Or
no.
The beginning of to establish a list. A list of.
Hidden treasures
and
like,
well, all over.
Oh, yeah.
A list of places to visit.
We should start on Van Nuys.
Informed places to visit, not just places to visit.
What's John's language on that?
Ask Dunn to do a community Saturday calendar of events for all NC members to learn more about the City of Angels. Secretary Hendry to reach out and establish a list of places to visit.
done, it's not gonna do it, okay,
I mean, after that, you can go, you can run with it, I mean, we just gotta. So I make a motion, we adopt that language as is, with that, I call for the vote.
Just a second, okay, President Thomas?
Yes.
Secretary Hendry, aye, Treasurer Hopper?
Aye.
Mr. Zaritz?
Aye.
Very good, anybody else have anything for the agenda, Karina?
George, can you clarify that, are we gonna discuss on the roles, between the chairs? Is that?
We can, or when situations like this arise, we will just go into a committee on the whole and hash it out without the whole council.
Okay, so that.
I mean, that's what they do, with other parliamentary,
Bodies.
Yes, and, that, this is probably why, and, the wheels will keep turning.
Okay.
Anybody else have anything for the agenda? Ms. Raines?
I just wanna say that my goal is to have the agenda for August 19th for next Wednesday, so when that item comes up, we're also voting on the agenda.
Good.
But hopefully, I'm trying to get that.